guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Meg. If you are a returning viewer or subscriber, welcome back. Today we're gonna talk about where do I get my bags? Right, so if you've been here for a while, you know that I have this thing for preloved luxury and mainly or specifically for bags, as you can probably tell. Now, most of my bags are preloved. The only ones that have been bought new are my Coach bags, 1, 2, 3. This one from the Handbag Crave, 4. And this one, which is the Tory Burch, the latest addition to the collection. Tory Burch Kira Mini Kira. How beautiful is that? It looks actually really good on camera. It's bejeweled. And it's lambskin, right? Anyway, this was bought secondhand, but it was brand new with tags when I bought it. The original owner never used it, so like it still had the styro cover. That's how new it was. Like it was never brought out. Anyway. And if you follow me on Instagram, you probably would have seen me wearing that. So where do I get my bags? If you're curious, although nobody really asked. But there are three main places that I get them from. And those are the three main places that I sell on as well. Okay. So if you've been following me, you probably would have seen... Oh, sorry. My YSL clutch is also brand new. I bought this from the boutique, and if you've seen my vlog before, you would have seen me unbox this. Right, anyway, as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted by myself, so I usually would buy them from Facebook Marketplace, eBay, and Vestiaire. Now, Facebook Marketplace used to be my go-to to buy secondhand bags. But there are a few things that are, let's say, pros and cons about buying from Facebook Marketplace. I do love selling my stuff on Facebook Marketplace because there are no fees, but there are also no regulations. Like, apart from you not being allowed to sell replicas, I've got a whole complaint about that, okay? Because I'm trying to sell my authentic, real bags, okay, and Facebook keeps on denying my posting, but I see all of this many replicas and fakes flooding Facebook Marketplace. So every time they deny my posting, I would report at least 10 fake bags. That's what I do. I'm vengeful. Anyway, so yeah, so Facebook Marketplace is probably one of the places that I would sell my bags first, but it has now become the last place that I would buy my bags from, simply because of what I've just said, that there are lots and lots of fakes and replicas and super fakes out there who are being passed on as real, okay? And if you're new to this whole luxury thing, it's very easy to get duped, okay? Because they even would show you, here's the receipt, and then it comes to you, and it's not, they probably have the real version of the bag, but then they'll send you the fake, you know? They're so smart, so conniving, so evil, right? They dupe you of your hard-earned money. Okay, and all of like the effort that you've put in saving that money to buy the real thing. Okay, so Facebook Marketplace, great for selling, not so much for buying, I would say, in my opinion. Or if you have the opportunity to get the item authenticated first, I would always ask for the receipt or authentication papers when I buy from Facebook Marketplace and even eBay. Because there's loads of fakes out there. I would always ask that. And if they refuse, like sometimes there's been a few occasions where I've asked the seller for more photos and said to them, I'd like to get it authenticated. Can you send me more photos? Like, I don't even ask them to have it authenticated themselves because obviously they don't want to spend that money. But if I'm going to buy it and I'm going to spend hundreds, even thousands of dollars on it, I'm going to get it authenticated. I'd rather spend that $15 to get it authenticated, okay, than to pay and then to pay hundreds and thousands of dollars just to get a fake, you know? So every time I would say that, if the seller is trying to pass on a fake as real, then they would stop responding to me. And that, then I get that, oh, okay, so maybe they don't want me to find out that it's not actually real and that they're trying to scam me out of my money, right? So that's one of the tactics that I actually use to make sure that, oh, they're not passing on a fake to me. So Facebook Marketplace is one, and that's one of the things that I always do. eBay is also a great place to find bags, especially if they're coming from Japan. When they're coming from Japan, I'm a bit more relaxed, I'd say, and comfortable in making that payment without authenticating the item first. Because I know in Japan, they're very strict with fakes. And before it gets sent out, their customs would inspect it, right? So, and they have their own authenticators for these companies, especially for bigger resellers in Japan, like Brand Off, Brandier, DCT Vintage, Amore Tokyo. They usually have their own authenticators to make sure that the bags are real. But also in Japan, you wouldn't be able to buy fakes anyway, so you can't resell a fake either. They're very strict on that. So if it's coming from Japan, fine, right? I'd rather I wait here. I wait and then when the item gets here, that's when I get it authenticated. I still get it authenticated no matter what, okay? But when it gets here, that's when I get it authenticated just for my own peace of mind. And I've never had any of my bags come back as fake, okay? If it's not coming from Japan, I always ask for authentication papers. I always ask for proof of authenticity, proof of purchase, receipt, whatever. Okay. And now the good thing about eBay is that they have the money back guarantee, especially for items that cost a bit more than normal, right? That's the thing with Facebook Marketplace. There is no such thing as money back guarantee. And I've heard of some cases because I'm part of a preloved luxury group and on Facebook that's based here in Australia. And I've heard of so many people tell us of stories where they've been scammed and they've reported it to the police and the police can't do anything. So at least with eBay, you can dispute it. If you are sold a fake bag without you knowing that it's fake, or if they've passed it on as if it's real, even though it's fake, then you can at least get your money back. Okay, like I've had a situation in on eBay where it's not fake. It's a real Loewe satchel. Okay, it was a real Loewe satchel, but the description did not match the actual bag that came. In the description, they didn't mention that there was a dent on the back, and I think the dent actually happened from the way it was packaged. And then transported here, because it wasn't something that you can just like rub off or, you know, reform. It was like a real dent that was sort of going to be permanent for quite a long time. So I sent a picture of that and I disputed the purchase. And I said, hey, this wasn't in the pictures that you posted when it was advertised. It wasn't, I think it was improperly packaged, so it came like this. They've asked me to return it and I got my money back. And initially they said that if it was returned, then I would have to pay for the return shipping. But because the fault was in the packaging and the transport or the shipping to me, they didn't ask me to pay for the shipping back. They paid for it, the company, I think it was Brandier. I think that's what the company is called in Japan, right? So at least that's sort of like a safety net for you. Now, my favorite to buy from, but not to sell from, is Vessier Collective. Okay. Let's start with why I don't really like to sell at Vessier. So on Facebook, there are no fees, nothing, right? On eBay, there are fees, but it's minimal, and it's really not something that I mind. I just jack up the price a little bit to cover that cost, right? But with Vessier, the commission is quite high. I don't remember what exactly it is, but there are days when they would actually tell you, oh, if you post between this date and this date, and the price of your item is less than $800, then you would be charged only half of the commission that we usually charge. That's why when I posted my Dior Boston bag there, I priced it at exactly $800. Anyway, I'm going to put the details somewhere on the screen so you know. But yeah, it's a little bit heftier on Vessier Collective, unless you catch those deals. So that's why I'm not really a big fan of selling with them. But I love buying from them. And the number one reason why I love buying from Vessier Collective, and I've bought my Chanel 19 is from there, my Tory Burch Kira is from there, my Balenciaga hip bag is from Vessier as well. Was there something else? I think that's it. Yeah, so I've bought from them three times or probably four. I might have already sold the fourth item that I bought from them. Anyway, I've bought from them before. And one of the biggest reasons why I buy from them is because they have their own authentication team. So what happens, unless you choose direct shipping or unless direct shipping is available on your purchase, usually the system is the seller would send out their, and I've done this as well because I've sold three items through Vessier Collective already. They would ask you to print the shipping label and it will ship to their office in Hong Kong, okay, before it gets shipped out to the actual buyer. When they receive it in Hong Kong, they will scrutinize it. They will look at the advert that you've put up versus the item that you've sent through. If there is anything that is inconsistent to what you've said on your advert, or if there was anything omitted, then they actually come back to you. And this has happened to me twice. I bought a Fendi, a Fendi wallet on chain. And the seller said, no packing, no any damage. That was the only thing that she's put in the description. She sent it out. It went to the office of Vessier Collective. They looked at it, and there was a stain in the interior lining of the wallet on chain. They messaged me and said, hey, this is what we found after the seller has sent us the item. It's not consistent with what they've said, that there is no damage. There is, in fact, a stain, a minor stain in the lining. But the lining of the wallet and chain was pink fabric. So it wasn't going to be easy to get that out. And even if I wanted to, it's probably going to damage the leather. So they've said that to me, and then they ask you the question, do you want to continue with the purchase? I decided to cancel. Okay, I was so looking forward to that, but hey, I don't want the hassle. And if she had shown me that stain, I probably would have negotiated the price. Okay, and then the first time that happened to me, I purchased a Chanel, it was a camel-toned accordion bag. That's what it was. When they had the 9-9 deals. And so I did that. In the description of that, it said that it would come with the authenticity card. When the seller shipped it, and she did message me, hey, I thought I had the authenticity card, but somehow it got lost. But she had already shipped it to to Vesture Collective. And I was like, yeah, okay. But after thinking about it, I was like, nah, I don't want an incomplete one. If you told me, and one of the factors that made me actually buy it was because it was coming with the dust bag and the authenticity card. So Vessier then again contacts me and says, everything was fine except that the authenticity card was not there, and that was advertised as being included. So I decided I didn't want to go through with it anymore. So I got my refund. They sent the bag back. And the seller actually contacted me and said, hey, I thought we were okay. And I said, yeah, I don't think I want to do that anymore, because one of the factors that I was considering when I was going to buy this was because you said that it came with the whole package, but it's not. So anyway, that's that. So that's why I like buying from Vessier, because they actually have that security feature wherein they authenticate the item, they scrutinize it, make sure that it's exactly as how it was advertised, and if there are any discrepancies, they actually get in touch with you and ask you, so that you still have that chance to change your mind before committing to it. So that's one of the reasons why. And this is not sponsored by eBay or Facebook or Vessier Collective. Okay, I'm just sharing my experience with them. But again, in terms of selling, it's not my first go-to, because it can get expensive with the commission fees. But I also understand that the reason why that's expensive is because of that security that they give you. And so far, anything that I have purchased from Vessier that I have decided to continue has been great. I have not had any issues about authenticity, because even though they've been authenticated by Vessier, I still get them authenticated when it gets here in Australia. That's just for me, to keep me from losing sleep over bags. Right. Okay, so I hope that my sharing my experiences with these three platforms have been helpful. There are two other platforms, which is Depop and Poshmark here in Australia. I know Poshmark is not available everywhere. Depop is okay, but again, there's a lot of fakes out there. I also don't like that they only allow you to post 4 photos and a video of the item, or that it's really difficult to have, like, if I wanted to ask for more photos, I can't do it through their chat function because it doesn't allow to upload images. So I have to give out my phone number to the seller so that they can text me the pictures. So Depop is not very user friendly, in my opinion. Poshmark is super expensive, super expensive. They take 20% of anything that is under a certain amount, and then I think it's a specific amount. If it's, I think it's $25 if it's under $100. If the value of the item is under $100, or I can't remember. Again, I'll put it on the screen. But it's super expensive, so much so that you have to jack up the price of your item just to be able to recoup that and not lose any money. Like my friends in the preloved seller community, who sells like secondhand clothing, they can't sell on Poshmark because it's almost like, they can't really jack up their prices too much, because clothing doesn't really cost that much when it's pre-loved, especially when you've got so many charity shops around. So it just doesn't make sense to jack up the prices that much to cover the expenses. So yeah, I don't really like Poshmark. Nah, I haven't sold. Well, I've sold one item there, which was a pair of Coach sunglasses, and I've been very specific about my descriptions, as I always am. And then the buyer comes back with a feedback that I wasn't specific on my adverts, and I was like, how much more specific do you want? I told you the color, the size, I even gave you the case, even though I didn't advertise that I was going to give you the case. Like, I was like, if this is the kind of customers I'm going to get from here, I'm not going to bother with that. So anyway, yeah. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. Let me know as well, where do you buy your bags? If you don't buy them on the boutiques, or if you don't buy them brand new, where do you buy your bags? And where do you sell your the ones that you don't love anymore? Bye.